Welcome to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq. Joining me is Kate Duchene, CEO of Nasdaq-listed RGP, to discuss the future of work trends and long-term implications of the trends that were accelerated during the pandemic. Kate, it's great to meet with you. Welcome to Trade Talks.
Thanks so much, Jill. Nice to be here.
Thank you. And RGP is a next-gen global human capital firm helping businesses match the right professional talent needed to tackle change and transformational initiatives. How is the professional gig workforce enabling companies to transform their businesses and workplaces?
Right. So coming out of COVID, it's all about resiliency now. And so companies are changing their workforce strategies to focus on skills gaps, not so much roles anymore. Everyone is looking for agility and resilience. So we're helping companies think about how do you fill those skills gaps with more flexibility and to better match the transformation initiatives that are on everyone's agendas.
And there has been a lot of discussion on future of work trends in the post-COVID workplace over the past year. What are the long-term implications of the trends that have been accelerated during the pandemic?
So again, I turn back to agility, but COVID has accelerated that trajectory. Every company has a list of transformation. Every business is getting disrupted at a pace of change that we haven't seen before. So what companies are doing are thinking about their workforce strategies, much like their supply chain strategies, and saying, what do we need for now? What do we need for 6 months from now? And how are those skill sets going to change? And then deciding how to fill those needs in more agile, more flexible, and more creative ways. So we're going to start seeing HR departments, for example, need to manage different talent groups. Not everyone's going to be an employee in the future. You're going to pull talent from different demographics, different kind of relationships to give you that agility that you need to compete and win.
As economies attempt to emerge from the pandemic, some businesses are rolling out their return to office plans. What are you seeing in terms of how businesses are thinking about the future workplace?
So I think it'll be hybrid. I think it will play into this idea of radical flexibility. I mean, what COVID has taught many of us through the past year is that people want flexibility, not only in where they do their work, when they do their work, but the kind of work they're engaged in. So a hybrid approach will be the answer for the future. I think the other big picture item is that one size doesn't fit all. So you're going to have to talk to the different demographics in your workforce and determine what works for them and plan accordingly.
And how has the remote work environment in the past 15 months reshaped workforce strategies across the board?
Probably the biggest impact has been that the global talent pool has opened up exponentially. It used to be that I think companies felt that talent needed to sit side by side and physically be in the same location. I mean, who thought you'd do a public company audit remotely or complete an M&A transaction remotely? All of those activities have happened successfully in the past 12 months. So what that means for companies is you don't need your talent on site all the time. And therefore, in looking for the skill set, you can really broaden your search. It's no longer the zip code. It's really the time zone that you worry about.
And Kate, with that said, are you seeing a heightened demand for on-premise projects as we're getting to the other side of the pandemic?
We're seeing a blend. We're seeing some clients want to say kick off a project in person, but then there's an awful lot that can be done remotely. And both providers and buyers of professional services want to reduce cost. And so what we've learned through the pandemic is that an awful lot can be done remotely and more cost effectively with the automation tools and the collaboration tools that exist today.
And how are businesses filling skill set gaps in anticipation of post-COVID demand?
So one important aspect that we're seeing in our client base is that agile talent is getting a place on the org chart now, which means that companies are really understanding that a component of their need will be filled by agile talent. What we're doing at RGP is building a digital engagement platform, for example, that will allow both talent and clients to connect digitally to fill those skill gaps in real time. Everyone wants speed. Everyone wants perfect match. And so we're building some new digital tools to enable clients to have that. We call it high tech and high touch.
And Kate, we continue to hear about the particularly jarring impact that the pandemic has had on women in the workforce. How should industries and businesses address the female flight that we've seen?
Yeah, we have to be creative. We have to put our creative hats on and understand what that demographic of skill set needs. So probably they've left the workforce because the demands of child rearing and homeschooling became too much. So as we think about attracting them back, let's do it with flexibility in mind. What do they need? When do they need to deliver those services? Do they need to stay remote as opposed to being on premise? How do we give them opportunities on a project basis to come back and work for, say, 3 months and then take some time off? We need to blend different strategies in order to be creative and attract that highly skilled group back into the workforce.
All right, Kate, appreciate the insight. Thanks for joining us on Trade Talks. And thanks for joining me. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at NASDAQ.
Thanks, Jill.